Online video marketing. How to get more followers and convert them into paying customers with YouTube marketing and Instagram marketing. Written by International Management School and narrated by Carl Johnson and John Smith.
Build your tribe. Introduction. Social media platforms like Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram make creating and posting content for a potential audience of billions almost effortless. Before social media's rise in popularity, businesses would gain customers through traditional advertising techniques. With traditional advertising, you have to know how to brand your business. Letting your customers know what your company is about and everything that goes with it. This allows consumers to see how it is different from your competitors. Using social media is no different from traditional advertising techniques, in that it is a direct reflection on your business and what it can do for your customers. To establish your brand on the various social media platforms, there are a few things that you must do to ensure that your brand is what you want it to be. A good brand will be engaging to customers, will give them the opportunity to see that you are different from your competition, and will put your business in the best light possible. To build a loyal social media following, you have to focus your efforts on being consistent, providing great visuals, doing it differently, and go for simplicity. Choosing the right social media network and the right way to advertise your business will enable you to make sure that you are getting the most out of your social media marketing campaign. While you can eventually build up to having more than one network, when you are first building your social media branding, it is better to start out with a single platform because it will be easier to manage as you learn what works and what doesn't. There are ways that you can determine which social media platform will work best for you. Using Facebook for your business. Facebook is one of the largest and most widely recognized social media platforms in the world. Billions of people have personal profiles on this site, and thousands of businesses have active pages, from connecting with old classmates to getting deals for local companies. You can do just about anything on the site. You can even play games that are directly connected to the site. The only problem with Facebook is that there is a lot that you can do as a business owner, and offers a ton for the people who want to visit your page, which can make getting started with the platform confusing. There are specially designed algorithms that will direct people to your page, even if you don't invite them. The algorithms are in constant flux, but Facebook is always coming up with new ways to make sure that they are fair to all businesses who have pages. They want to make sure that companies who place their trust in the site can get the traffic they need, making it necessary for the site to change the algorithms regularly. This can make it extremely difficult to get organic traffic to your Facebook page. But it's not impossible. There are a few things that you can do to ensure that you are getting the most out of your Facebook page and build a loyal following. Entering your information. Facebook has a convenient feature that you can use in designing your business page. It works much in the same way that a wizard would work to help you set something up, ensuring that you don't forget to include all of your essential business information. It will ask you for your business name, your hours of operation, the website address, and some other information that is important for making your business page stand out. It will also ask you to describe your business. It is essential that the description that you provide is accurate and reflects the values that you hold as a company. If you want people to see your business and follow your brand, this is extremely important. While SEO isn't necessarily functional on Facebook in the same way that it works for your website, there is nothing wrong with adding some natural keywords to your information, especially your description. You will want to do some keyword research to find out the best words to use in your description, utilizing the top keywords for your business. For example, car wash in Seattle, bed and breakfast in New Orleans, homestyle restaurant in Denver, boutique clothing in Reno. These are just some examples of how you can incorporate SEO into your business description on Facebook to drive more traffic to your Facebook page. Adding pictures. As you set up your business page, one of the first things that Facebook will ask you for is a profile picture. This picture needs to be a reflection of your business. You can use a picture that shows a collection of your products, a photo that features the front of your business, or even a picture of you or one of your employees performing a service that you offer. The profile picture should at least look semi-professional and should always reflect what you want people to see about your business. It should be relevant and easy to understand what is going on in the picture. Another picture that Facebook will ask you for is a cover photo that will be displayed at the top of your page. For this, you should consider designing a photo that features the name of your business and your contact information, even if you have already included this information on your page. It's always a good idea to use your logo in your cover photo. Having the cover photo contain your contact information will make it easier for customers to contact you when they are ready to do business or if they have a question. Creating daily updates. Once you have your business page set up, the most invaluable thing you can do is to use it. Make sure that you're posting about your business on a regular basis, ensuring that the information you share is relevant to your company and industry. While you want to avoid having all your posts focused on things like sales and promotional material, Facebook is an excellent place to post any discounts you are offering or deals that might be going on in your business. In general, you want to limit these types of posts to no more than once a week to avoid your customers getting annoyed with your blatant sales promotions. While it can be challenging to post something to your Facebook business page every day, especially if you don't have a social media manager, you should make sure that you find a way. To help make it a bit easier, you can schedule future posts through a convenient and easy-to-use tool that is offered by Facebook. Or you can use a free or low-cost online tool like Hootsuite. Take time once a week to create the posts and schedule them so that they will automatically post when you want them to throughout the week. Remember to plan them at different times throughout the day. According to numerous studies, the best times to post to Facebook are 9 a.m., 1 p.m., and 3 p.m. Using real content. When you post to Facebook, you want to be sure that you are posting high-quality content. The general rule of thumb is that no more than 20% of your posts should be promotional, leaving the other 80% to be value-added content, including articles on subjects related to your business and industry. This will show your customers that you are connected to the industry. One thing that you need to be sure to avoid is posting content, articles, or links on controversial topics. Don't post things that are political in nature, or anything that could make it seem like you are taking one side of a controversial issue. Generally, you want to keep your business page on Facebook lighthearted and avoid any heavier topics that could upset some of your potential customers. The last thing you want to do is lose potential customers over a post you made, even if it is something that you feel strongly about on a personal level. Connect with yourself. Something that you need to be sure to do is get personal with your own Facebook page. You want your personal profile to be as professional as possible, so that you can connect it to your business page. One thing that you may want to do is post content on your business page from your own Facebook personal page. Consider posting links a couple times a week on your page, but use your personal Facebook page to post from. Connecting your personal profile to your business profile is a great way to make sure that people know who you are as the face of the company. Most consumers like to see that there is a face behind the business. They don't want businesses and organizations to continually be posting, especially if they never know what type of person is behind the company. When you connect your business page to your personal profile, you are putting a face to your business. People will be glad to see who is working behind the scenes and who runs the company. It is a good idea to try and make a personal connection with your customers to earn their loyalty. Take advantage of buttons. Facebook has a fun feature that no other social media platform offers: a button feature. When setting up your profile, you can add a button to your profile. Generally, the button will go on your cover photo. The button can be set as a way for people to call you, go to your website, or message you on Facebook. Instantly. It allows consumers to make an instant connection with your company. Your customers will love how convenient you've made it for them to contact you. Another benefit of having a button on your business profile is that it is a clickable option. For the most part, Facebook requires users manually to have to message each other to try and find the information that they need to be able to search something. The button feature makes it easy for your audience to contact you, because when they click on it, they are immediately redirected to your phone number, website, or the Messenger app, so they can send you a message about something that they want to speak to you about. Gather reviews. Every time that you do business with someone, don't be afraid to ask them for a review. No matter how many times the algorithms change on Facebook, the reviews you get will play into it in some way. This is something that will make your business look better and will enable you to show up more often in searches using the keywords that are related to your business. You can even ask your family and friends to leave you a positive review. People can leave reviews without purchasing things, giving your business a bit of a boost. The review that your friends and family leave aren't even lies. They know the kind of work you do, and they are proud of the work, so they are just letting others know. Something that you need to keep in mind is that all 5-star reviews will look suspicious on your Facebook profile. There isn't a single business that does perfect work, so make sure to keep that in mind. Having a 4-star once in a while is not going to hurt your rankings, and may even make your business seem more legitimate. Respond to messages. No matter the type of message a customer sends you, it is vital that you respond to it. The more that you respond to customers, the more that you will be seen as a legitimate business on Facebook. The site will track when you respond to messages and how long it takes you to respond. Customers will also take notice of this and will begin to realize just how much their business means to you. It is a good idea to continue to respond to your customers no matter what they are talking about. If you are exceptionally good at responding to messages from your customers, you will get a special badge on your Facebook page that shows that you are quick to respond to messages, which can increase your rankings for people who want to find your page. As long as you respond to people within an hour of receiving the message, and you do this consistently, Facebook will put the badge on your profile. This will help you to increase the number of people who come to your page and who want to be able to connect with you and shop with your business. Talk to customers. Along with being willing to talk to your customers when they send you messages, you need to connect with them if they leave a comment on your page, or they say something to you on the page. This will allow you to make a good connection with your customers and provide you with a great opportunity to resolve any problems that they may have. Always leave the option on that allows people to post to your page. If someone posts a negative comment about your business, or if they choose to post a complaint or problem on your page, it is important that you address it immediately. Don't be rude to them, and treat the comment just like you would if they walked into your business with the same issue. This will provide you with the opportunity to show people how you respond to negative feedback. Utilizing YouTube. YouTube is the most popular video sharing site in the world, and was one of the first social media sites that allowed you to post videos that they had made into an online format. It predates even smartphones and has allowed people to make a name for themselves in the online world. Unlike the other social media platforms, YouTube focuses solely on video. While users of the social media site have the ability to comment on the videos that people have posted, and those who create the video can respond to the comments, there is no messaging system, and there is no timeline that has the information of the people who are on the videos. Even the profile of the video creator is limited to information about the videos that they make. The benefit of using YouTube is that you can reach millions of people, and there isn't a complicated algorithm to keep up with. YouTube has mostly used the same type of algorithm since they first started, allowing people to search for profile pages and videos. There are a few steps that you can take to make sure that your YouTube channel is the best option possible for your business, and to ensure that your customers are going to be drawn to it. You can utilize YouTube as a useful marketing tool. It works exceptionally well for people who want to be able to make sure that they are getting the most out of their experience on YouTube. While it is an excellent option for businesses who sell services, because they can show off those services, you're also able to effectively sell products on the site by creating videos of your products in use. Setting up your account. The most important thing that you need to do when setting up your YouTube business channel is to make sure that you can actually have a channel for your business. If you already have a YouTube account, this means making changes to the account you already have. If you don't have a YouTube account already, you can set it up using a Google account, or even from your Gmail account. You will only need a small amount of information to get your YouTube business channel set up correctly. When setting up your YouTube account, you want to be sure to have it connected to your business email. This is important to keep your personal channel separate from your business channel. Avoiding any crossover that may come from the two channels is essential. The people who have decided to view your business may not want to see that you can crack an egg one-handed. Your YouTube channel should be primarily used for business videos. Some ideas that you can do for business videos is showing off the products that you have. Take some time to make videos of how to use your products, showing your employees performing the services that you offer. And you can even provide promotions on your video that people can take advantage of. It is a good idea to take inspiration from each of these ideas and create a separate channel for each. All of the videos that you post on your channel should be related to your business. No matter what type of video you choose to create, they should also be able to help support the idea that you are doing the most with your business. Making your channel. The channel that you create needs to be related to your business and should only feature videos of your business. Once you have created your account, you can go in and create different channels. In the beginning, try to stick with just a single channel to keep things less confusing. This will also allow you the chance to make sure that you are getting the most out of the experience. The videos that you are going to upload should be directly related to your business. If you want to share videos that other people have created for the industry, make sure that you ask them first before adding them to your channel. You want to make sure that the channel you add these videos to is separate from your own business channel, so that people can see that there is a difference. When it comes to creating a name for the channel, you want to make sure that you always include your business name in the channel name. For example, how to create flawless outfits from Catherine's Boutique, Todd's IT Services Best Computer Tips. Including your business name in the channel name gives viewers the opportunity not only to see the name of your business, but also how you do business. Try to avoid making your channel names too specific to prevent the exclusion of anything important. You never want to put specific ideas or even particular tip into the channel title. Uploading videos. Once you've established your YouTube account and have set up a channel with the title and information that your customers need to reach you, you can start to upload your videos. If you are going to upload your videos, you need to be sure that they are connected to your account. When uploading videos, it is important to be careful with the content that you use. You can't film any of your customers without their express written permission. Also, try to avoid using money terms or prices in your video, because if these change, it could cause you a massive headache. Always choose quality over quantity. As you begin to make your videos, you have to think about what your customers might want to see. Do they want to see a video that is blurry, grainy, and shaky? Or do you think they want to look at videos that are high quality and look like they've been done by a professional? You always have to consider your customers and have a good understanding of what they like. If you want to create a video that they will enjoy watching on your channel, the best part of making videos that look professional is that you don't have to hire a professional videographer to get it right. You want to get the most out of your experience and have videos that you are proud to share. When shooting a video, always use a tripod to eliminate any shaking, and consider using a real camera instead of your cell phone. When you make high-quality videos, you won't have to increase the quantity that you create to make up for the poor quality. While YouTube doesn't have complicated algorithms like Google or Facebook, you can still use the search engine feature to your advantage. Try to find the keywords that are associated with your video and include them in your title. This will allow you the opportunity to ensure that people can locate your videos. By putting keywords in your title, people can more easily find your videos and will be able to get what they need out of the films. To determine what keywords to use in your videos, you need to think about the content they contain. Think about what words you would use to search for the content in your video. You can either use software to help you determine this, or you can ask your family and friends what keywords they would use in the search engine to find a video like yours. This will allow them to give you the keyword terms that you need to put into the title of your video. The name you give your video can make or break the number of views that you get. Call to action. As with any of your marketing efforts, you need to have a call to action with your videos. It is vital that you have something in your video that tells people to shop with you. The call to action tells your audience that there is so much more to your business. It can be as simple as saying, "If you're ready to see the difference in blank, then come visit us at blank." This is the most basic call to action that you can customize to fit your business. You want to be sure to keep it short and uncomplicated. When it comes to your call to action, you should always place them at the end of your videos. If it appears at the beginning of your video, people will forget about it by the time they finish viewing the content, especially if the content is engaging. If you place it in the middle of your video, it can seem like too much of a sales pitch and could result in your audience leaving your channel before they get to the end of the video. By putting it at the end, your call to action will be fresh in their minds. Tweeting about your business. While Facebook is all about making the overall connection with your customers, and YouTube is about making videos to show your customers what your business is about, Twitter is about showing your customers what you have going on during the day through quick blurbs. Twitter is a quick and easy way for customers to check up on a business and the world in general because of its easy-to-use platform. If you've never used Twitter before, here's a quick rundown of the site. Twitter allows you to create 280 character posts about anything that you want. It is easy to say a few words about something, leave it there, and go about your day without having to worry about writing long posts and drawn-out content. Twitter regularly updates their feeds, which means your feed can drastically change from 1 minute to the next. It is a high-speed recollection of everything that is going on in the world, from current events to business news, to opinions that people have on a variety of subjects. When it comes to your business, you should be using the platform to tweet about things that are going on in the industry and things that are relevant to your business. Your business's first tweets. The most important thing about your first tweet is that it is getting your company's name into the Twitter universe. Before you send out your first tweet, it is important that you fully finish setting up your account. The first tweet that you send should be something that is witty and clever to grab your audience's attention. While you can create a free account on Twitter, you may want to consider paying for the business version so you can take full advantage of the advertisement feature that you can use on Twitter to help you get more followers. When it comes to the platform, only business accounts can take advantage of the ability to advertise. It is vital that you make sure that the first few tweets you send include a link to your website. If you don't want to waste characters, you can use URL changes to make your URL much smaller. It is also a good idea to post at least one picture with your first few tweets. While Twitter isn't necessarily the best place to advertise your photos, it does allow you to share images and show your followers what your company is up to. Following others. Once you've set up your account, you'll want to start following other users of the site. Follow your personal Twitter account and other businesses that are similar in nature to yours, as well as industry insiders. You can also follow news and other informational accounts. But be cautious with these, because it can turn out to be detrimental to your business if you show people how you feel about specific controversial topics. With 100 million active daily users on Twitter, there are more than enough options regarding people and businesses that you can follow on the site. There is no limit to who or what you can follow on the site, so be sure to follow as many people as you want. This is one of the best ways for you to expose your business to the world and try to get the followers that you need without having to ask for them to pay for advertising. When you follow a business or resources that are related to your business or industry, you give yourself and your business a better chance to gain more customers and increase traffic to your business website. It also allows you to show people that you are relevant and that you know the hot topics in your industry. Retweeting. Similar to Facebook, retweeting means sharing someone else's original tweet. Doing this allows you to connect with other companies that are related to your industry. This is especially true with larger companies like wholesalers.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.